Hello, my dear kids. Very good afternoon. This is Sundar Rabindranathan here. Just give me a minute. Hey guys, am I audible? It was kind of echoing for me. Hi guys, sorry about the initial hiccup, guys. So welcome to this session where we'll be dealing with touch screen. So many times we would have wondered how this, what is this touch screen? What are the different types of touch screen? What did they say initially? They were saying LED, then they said LCD initially, they said, then they said LED. Now we also have AMOLED, right? So what are these things? How do they work? Okay, so this is going to be a kind of a crisp you know, refresher on what is or what are touch screens all about. Okay, so guys, as usual, we'll just leave probably a minute for other guys to jump in and then we will start the session. Hi Bharti, I am fine. Hi Rupesh. Hi Jeevansh. Ankur. Now itself, who wants Menti? Who is that? Hi Kritanjali. Okay. Little Mayank, yesterday also you pinged me. How will I forget you? Hi Shreya. Great guys, so slowly we will move on. By the time, I think, I hope others will also jump in to the session and join us. So guys, Vedantu Young Wonders, yes, we are a channel for 6th, 7th and 8th. Typically, these three grades is our point of focus. The well-being of the kid belonging to these grades, specifically from both academic as well as non-academic front, is our vision. Okay, so academically, we teach you the entire syllabus for math, science, social and English grammar for all the three grades, 6, 7 and 8. So entire year syllabus, it's going to happen till November or December. We'll be continuing. Once we complete the entire year syllabus, we will start with the revision sprints. Okay, right. On non-academically, series like what we are having now, how does it work? Different small equipments, something that we want to know about. How does a pressure monitor work? How does a fitness band work, right? Small things, but once we know or once you guys learn or understand the technology behind, you don't know, it's going to add a lot to your knowledge quotient. Okay, so that's the objective. Non-academically, we also have spoken English series conducted by Pritesh sir. We also have Spell Bee contest on Sundays. Guys, overall, great channel to be. Okay, please subscribe to the channel if you're new. And I'm sure, you know, you will be amazed at the kind of live sessions that we will be doing. Okay. Hi, Devyani and Mansi. Long time. Hi, Shivani Senthil. Nagamani. Hi. Hello, Mehak. Yes, I do, guys. Arav. Many more happy returns of the day, Arav. So, guys, I'm going to start the session with people are jumping in to the session. Slowly, they are coming in. Very quick piece of announcement. Guys, in case you are wondering, you know, what is the difference between a struggling learner and a very bright learner? Bright learner, generally, they don't leave any doubts unsolved. If you start with a small doubt and you don't get solved, you know, go get that solved, slowly doubts start piling up. And at one point in time, you lose your confidence when it comes to learning a subject. That's why doubt solving is a must. So if you are looking for unlimited doubt solving and you are also looking for unlimited access to Vedantu's live sessions from best teachers in India, Vedantu's master teachers, This is the subscription you guys should watch out for. vdnt.in/ytpro. It's called Vedantu Pro subscription. Note down that. Atharva, this is general knowledge. Any class can get into it. No problem at all. So vdnt.in/ytpro is the link for that subscription. Go to that. Note down my teacher code to avail a discount also. Almost a 30% discount. Okay. So go to that link. And where it is asking for a coupon code, type that SRPRO, my teacher code. You're going to get that discount. Okay. Right. Wow, Rajni. Awesome. Thank you. Hi, Mahimanvita. Nehalata, you want me to talk in Hindi? Yo, everyone should understand, right? Very important it is. Hi, Prasad Yadav. Great, guys. Great. You guys are awesome. Thank you, Nagamani. Miscellaneous acid. What is this name here? Miscellaneous acid. Okay. TG. Probably, I do not know whether I am a best teacher or not, but you guys are the best students. Niranjan, many more happy returns of the day, Niranjan. May God bless you. Okay, guys. So, moving on. Now, let us speak about the different types of displays, especially touchscreens. Guys, touchscreen generally a touchscreen is an input as well as an output device. Okay, an input as well as an output device. Okay, so what happens is the touchscreen is layered at the top of a visual display system. Whenever you want to process some information and you want that to be transactional, interactive in nature, this touchscreen display, it's like a sheet. Let me put it this way in simple terms for you. It is laid on top of that display system. All right. It can sense the coordinates with different technologies. If you're touching on something, it senses the coordinates on where you touched it. Sometimes you touch with one finger, sometimes you touch with multiple fingers. It starts recognizing it. So there are different types of touchscreen. Something which can touch only, you know, sense only one touch at a time. Some touchscreens can sense multiple touches at the time. So there are different types of touchscreens as well. But in general, touchscreens are nothing but interactive electronic visual display systems. All right. So which are laid on top of any display. Clear? Right. Now, generally you have an LCD or an LED display. LCD, guys, so one thing I wanted to tell you. Remember this. LED is not something which is very unique and all. LED is also LCD only. Okay. LCD has two different ways of displaying. One is using a CCFL. All right. Cold cathode fluorescent lamps. To put that, to emit that lighting, you know, to create that display and emit that lighting. Initially they were using something called cold cathode fluorescent lamps. That was one technology. However, now there is something called in the same display, there was something called LED. Light emitting diodes were used to emit that light. The display is always LCD only. So what is LCD? You create a display by putting two polarizing sheets. What is polarizing, guys? Polarizing sheets, and in between that you will have a crystal, you know, liquid crystal, you call it as, to ensure that the display is super awesome. And especially when you press on an LCD, you know, depending on the type of the LCD, you will find, you know, the monitor, you will find that liquid crystal kind of dissipated. Have you observed it, my dear kids? When you press on an LCD screen, the liquid crystal gets dissipated. You could see that. But in LED, it will not happen. There is a difference. Okay. We will come to who invented this and all. Hold on. First, understand what is liquid crystal display and what is LED. LCD is one where CCFL was used for emitting that, like creating that lighting. Something called cold cathode fluorescent lamps were used. That was initially LCD. But now everywhere light emitting diodes, which are the LEDs, which are the ones which are being used. So LED is also LCD, with not instead of a what do you say, the CCFL, you have diodes, light emitting diodes. So if someone is saying LCD and LED separately, LED is also an LCD, but the lighting happens with the form of a light emitting diodes. In LCD, pure LCD, lighting happens in the form of a CCFL. Cold, right? Yes. Cathode fluorescent lamps. My dear kids, now you know the difference between LCD and LED. LCD is something that uses CCFL, and LED is an LCD with LED lit display. Simple. Are you clear? Give me a yo so that I can move on. Sir, who invented? Who invented? You guys want to know who invented? Okay, it was invented initially, you know, I wouldn't say the conceptualized by Eric Johnson. I repeat, my dear kids, if you ask me who invented it, it was conceptualized by Eric Johnson in 1965. Okay, and however, patented after 10 years by Samuel Hurst. That's in, I think, US. Eric Johnson, I think he was in UK, if I'm not wrong. Okay, so now moving on. Types of touchscreen. Look at how many types of touchscreens are there. Resistive, surface capacitive, projected capacitive, surface acoustic waves. That is sound related. I will tell you, it's very, very, very interesting. And infrared. Infrared is something that you see in ATMs, right? ATM touchscreens are generally infrared in nature. Okay? Right. Oh, thank you, Rajini. Thank you. Right. So, my dear kids, now let's see what is resistive touchscreen display. All right. Let's see all these five, okay? So that you know what all the different touchscreens, how they work. Now, when it comes to resistive, all of you remember, this was generally used in older monitors and all. We had monitors, right? In banks and all, you see some monitors where the touchscreen is there. That is the type of touchscreen that they that used to be. Whenever we have very less transaction, these kind of very less touches, it is used sparingly, etc. It was the initial one, resistive touchscreen, it is called as. So, you know what happens here, resistive touchscreen. Guys, generally for touch display, you will find something called ITO is used. Indium tin oxide. It's a conductor which allows that current to pass in. That is when you press it, you will find that it is able to detect the charge. Indium tin oxide. Okay, the chemical. It is mixed with that sheet. Okay. So now coming back to resistive touchscreen. Resistive touchscreen is initially used where this can detect only one touch. All of you remember this? Resistive touchscreen can detect only one touch. Clear? Now, so as you can see that there is, you know, a film, a thin film. If you press a resistive touch, right, you will find that where exactly you touch, there is a voltage that appears, you know, which detects that exact point. You call it as a touch point. I repeat, when a user touches the screen, there will be two layers, one on the bottom, one on the top. Okay, two layers. When you press it, you press the top layer and make it contact the bottom layer. And when it contacts, okay, the voltage starts differing because you have interrupted the voltage, right? The flow of the, you know, the current is interrupted. That is detected, and it identifies where exactly you have touched. Are you clear? When it comes to a resistive touchscreen, my dear kids, okay, there are two. You see, right? You see on your screen, ITO conductive coating. Both one at the top, one at the bottom. When you press it, and the top layer goes and touches the bottom layer, thereby disrupting the flow of current. And this change in voltage is detected by the system, and it finds out where you touched. And depending on the portion of the screen, it starts responding to you. It is called resistive touch screen. And one thing you have to remember here is, it can detect only one touch at a time. See guys, in iPhone and all, you can see, right? Even in, you know, iPhone or Mac and all, you can use multiple fingers. Even in, you know, Xiaomi mobiles, you can use two or three fingers to copy the screen, right? That multiple touch doesn't work here. Have you tried that? So my dear kids, now you do you understand what is resistive touch screen? Resistive touch screen is two layers, all right? The two metallic layers are placed on the top of your mobile. Depending on where you press the circuit in between, the flow of, you know, charge gets disrupted. And that change in voltage is detected, finding out where exactly you pressed in the mobile. In the display, it might not be a mobile, right? It's not a mobile at all. It could be in the monitor. Okay? Right. Sunil Prasad, sir, smart laptop also, we can touch for... See, there are a lot of laptops which are touchscreen laptops, right? My laptop is a touchscreen laptop. So, similar, display, the mechanism is absolutely the same. Except for that, the sheet is bigger. The size of the display is bigger. So now resistive touchscreen. I hope you guys are clear. Now coming to capacitive touchscreen. Okay. So here, capacitive touchscreens are the ones which are used even now. But in capacitive touchscreen itself, there are multiple different types of capacitive touchscreens. Right. Here, a transparent electrode layer is placed on top of the glass panel. Guys, I want all of you to understand this. See here, when we are conductors of electricity, human beings, correct? Electric current can pass through us. So that is the reason in a capacitive display, right? When we press the place in a capacitive display, the electrical charge from the mobile, it gets transferred onto us. The charge gets transferred onto us. We will not realize it. So when charge gets transferred, there is a loss there, right? There is a loss of charge there. That is detected. So when your finger touches a monitor screen, okay, you can see electrical charge transfers from the screen to the user. So suddenly the decrease in capacitance, the charge which is stored, it comes down because something a little is transferred to us. So that is detected by the sensors and they find out where exactly you touched. So if you're touching in three places, it can detect all the three. My dear kids, let me see. Yeah, see, Pinky is saying, sir, I understood. Mithali, it's very simple, Mithali. You have a mobile, right? Here you find that there is a clearly, you know, we are good conductors of electricity. Electricity can pass through us. So when you press, right? We have static current in our body. And when you press, immediately you will find that a little of the charge in the mobile, in the screen, it starts getting transferred to our body. Very little, which we can't find out at all. Very, very little. So suddenly there is loss of charge. The capacitance comes down in the mobile. And that is detected by the sensors around. It is called surface capacitive touchscreen because the change in the surface of the touchscreen is detected. It's called surface capacitive touchscreen. My dear kids, thank you, Devyani. Great. So now here, there is also something called as projected capacitive touchscreen. The only difference here is there are two layers of electrodes which are used in a projected capacitive touchscreen. So that means two fingers, three fingers, when you use, it can sense in a projected capacitive touchscreen. Nowadays, all mobiles that you see are projected capacitive touchscreens. Okay? It quickly identifies the charge. It transfers a little of charge from the screen to us, thereby suddenly dropping the capacitance. And wherever the drop in capacitance happens, quickly that is detected by the sensors. Okay? Right. So, if at all you want to know which material is used, it is iridium tin oxide in those layers. Okay. So, that means see here, this projected capacitive touchscreen can be used, activated with surgical gloves or cotton gloves, because charge, it can, you know, sense the charge, right? Both the surgical gloves or cotton gloves, they can be, you know, they can sense the charge. So, this kind of touchscreen can be detected with surgical gloves or cotton gloves. Okay. So, resistive touchscreen, capacitive, in that surface capacitive, projected capacitive. So, a projected capacitive screen is composed of a sheet of glass with transparent electrode films. When a finger comes into, you know, the contact, the ratios of the electric current changes and the computer detects the touch points. Guys, do you, you know, what happened? Oh no. Kids, am I audible to all of you? Suddenly, I'm losing track. My dear kids, okay. Sorry, I'm not able to see any of your chats, that's why. So, there is also one more technology in touch, which is called SAWT, SAWT, Surface Acoustic Wave Touch. Wave touch, as the name says, it's all about sounds. There will be vibrations which are generally happening, flowing inside the screen. And when you touch, you know, the touch screen disrupts the sound, the flow of the vibration, that is detected. It is called Surface Acoustic Wave Touch. Right? So, the vibrations will be flowing throughout the screen, and when you press it, you find that the entire disruption happens. You know, wherever you pressed, it cannot flow, right? The sound vibration cannot flow, and that is detected and identified as a touch point. It's called Surface Acoustic Wave Touch. So, this touch screen detects your fingers using sound and not the light. Okay, just give me a minute. Here we go. Why is it taking time? So, kids, I hope so. Let me explain to you. Ultrasonic sound waves are generated on the edges of the screen. Throughout the screen, they keep flowing. Right? When you touch, you are interrupting the wave vibration, the sound beams. And you are also absorbing some of the energy because that, you know, the static conduct current is there, right? So, the screen's microchip figures out where you touched it because of the disruption in the sound. So, awesome. Oh, I missed so many of your chats. So, guys, the last one, as I think I already spoke about this, you would have seen in movies and all, you find infrared rays passed everywhere, the beams, right? And wherever there is a disruption, the system can, the touch screen can sense that. Yeah, perfect. Awesome, kids. So see here, an infrared touch screen, it uses photocells, all right, and a light detector arranged on all sides, the opposite sides of the screen. You touch it, all right, automatically it senses the disruption in the light flow, the flow of light, and then it identifies where exactly is the touch point. Okay, Vishal is asking, sir, can it detect which finger was used? No. It will detect only the touch. It cannot detect what kind of touch and all. Are you understanding? It detects the touch and the nature of the sensor, which is our fingers. If it is a conductor, it operates. If it is a non-conductor, I'll tell you something. There are people who have something called as dead skin. There will be no conductor in their hand. There will be no flow of charges in their hand at all. When they touch the touch screen, nothing will work. I do not know whether you would have observed. There are a lot of people who come and complain, I am touching the screen, nothing is working. There are a lot of times where it has nothing to do with the display. It has something to do with the dead skin in your hand. So only when it is, the static current is flowing, it will start working. This touch screen display will start working. Otherwise, it will not work. Tane, I think infrared touch screens are used in a lot of banks, different places, where they feel that the lot of security is required. Even now, whenever it is something related to security and all, they use this. But at the same time, now this infrared touch screen is totally replaced by capacitive touch. ATMs are primarily the places where infrared touch screen is used. Okay? Who invented touchscreen? Touchscreen was invented by Eric Johnson, 1965. But patent was given to someone else called Samuel Hurst, 10 years later. So that's about it, guys. Hey, kids. Now you have a fair idea. Simply, what is LCD? What is LED? Something also called as AMOLED, you would have seen, right? Active matrix organic LEDs. Right? So instead of a separate layer for touch, it is integrated with the screen itself in AMOLED so that the display is lightning fast. All the pixels can be activated super fast. It's called AMOLED. Most of the recent Samsung mobiles, I have seen so many mobiles use this AMOLED concept. Active matrix, organic LEDs. Hi, Keresh Chedda. So, my dear kids, still this, are you clear? What is a touchscreen typically? Generally, what is a resistive and what is a capacitive touchscreen? Resistive touchscreen, only one touch can be detected at a time. Capacitive, in projected capacitive, multiple touches can be detected. Surface capacitive, no. Again, still there is a problem. And we also have, infrared touch, which is totally based on light. The infrared light beams, when it gets disrupted, it. And we also have something called sound-based, SOT, surface acoustic wave touch, where the sound vibration, sound beams keep traveling in the screen. When you press it, there is a disruption with which it detects where exactly you pressed. Are you clear? If you guys are clear till this, I'm going to jump to Menti. Are you guys confident? Shall I move to Menti? Okay, Asmi is asking, sir, how do touchscreen recognize fingerprints? Touchscreen will not recognize fingerprint. It is biometric. That's totally a different technology. They are not touchscreens. They are biometric. Fingerprints are recognized by the light beams. not the touch. I hope you are understanding. Who is that? Ask me, are you clear? So biometric is totally different from touch screen. Okay? Guys, this is also a good one. One day I will take biometrics also for you. How does a biometric sensor work? How is that when there are crores and crores of people, if I just press on fingerprint, it is able to recognize it is Sundar who is touching it. We will take one day biometrics also. Okay, someone is asking, who was that? Piano Pro, a projected capacitive touch screen. Typically, two layers of electrodes are used here. Okay, so and an IC chip for the sensors, typically. So when you press, okay, the ratios of electric currents change. It is in 3D, all the places you will find that the charges can be deducted whenever there is a disruption. So when you press, okay, there is a three-dimensional electrostatic field, I just told you. The change in the current is detected and they will be able to identify what is the touch point where you pressed. Clear? Right, guys, moving on to... Great. So, my dear kids, give me a yo, let's jump into Menti. Sir, will the screen get damaged if we play games? See guys, every sheet, the sheet that we were speaking about, right? That has its own lifespan. Depending on your usage, definitely it will get worn out after a later point in time. You cannot use it for your lifetime. Depending on your usage, it gets worn out. Okay? Kannan Karpanchetti. Is static energy necessary for all touchscreen? As of now, yes. Except this infrared and all. Infrared is totally different. Infrared as well as that surface acoustic wave touch is there, right? That do not require that. Because they detect the disruption in sound. Whatever touches it, they will detect it. However, the laptop touchscreens are there, right? They are similar. You touch it with even a stick, it will work. With your hand, it will work. However, most of the laptops nowadays, they require static current. That is your hand or a proper conductor. With that, you should touch. Otherwise, it doesn't work. Okay, guys. Moving on to Menti now. For people who are new. So, now you know different types of touchscreen. How do the touchscreens work? You know who invented it. You guys also know what is the chemical used, ITO, iridium tin oxide, and so Eric Johnson patented in 1965. Moving on to Menti now, you have to open a new window. Type www.menti.com, M-E-N-T-I, menti.com. Don't close YouTube, you will lose my voice. Open www.menti.com in a separate window and it will ask you for a code. The code for Menti is 804676. I repeat, 804676. Hi Srishti, I'm fine. How are you? Which mouse display does use on laptop? Premshila, I didn't understand your question, Premshila. Mine is a Samsung, guys. Come on guys, so quickly tell me, you know, regarding this, the first question I'm going to ask now, few minutes I'll call back. So guys, quickly, yeah, I think I've already spoken about Young Wonders already. So guys, I hope you are liking the series. It's informative for all of you. And do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Or you don't need to do anything. You see Vedantu Young Wonders logo right on your screen, on the bottom corner. Click on that logo and subscribe. That's it. Nothing else you need to do. Okay? Just click on that logo, Vedantu Young Wonders logo on your screen, and you will be able to subscribe. Yeah, in case you have missed the links for Vedantu Pro subscription, make a note of it. CCFL, coal, cathode, fluorescent lamps. So my dear kids, starting the quiz now, here we go. Harshita, the sensors, the presence of sensors depends on the technology. Generally at the back side, the complete panel, the sensors will be present on all four sides. Generally. Kanav, they are also capacitive touch screens. Very similar, no difference. Akash, then we have to take one more session for touchpad. It's a very similar technology, however. Guys, smartphone came only in 1990s in US here. Okay, 1990s in US. We are kind of 20 years behind US when it comes to usage of smartphones. Yeah, late 19, that too near 2000, millennial. Okay, first question on your screens now. Here we go. Guys, there are 5 questions, be ready. Which technology allows multi-touch gestures? Multi-touch. Resistive touchscreen, capacitive sensing, infrared or multi-touch technology? Which technology allows multi-touch? Is it resistive, is this capacitive, infrared or multi-touch technology? Come on guys, come on, come on, come on. Come on guys, don't break my heart. Let me see. Guys, how many times I first thing what I explained you was resistive. And I said it allows only one touch. 69 of you have chosen multi-touch for resistive. Is it not? First type of technology what I explained you was resistive. And I said the biggest difference is it allows only one touch. Now we are speaking about multi-touch. It is capacitive. There is nothing called multi-touch technology at all. I didn't explain anything called as multi-touch technology, right? Did I? I explained only two, resistive and capacitive. Under capacitive, I explained multiple things. And I explained you surface wave touch and infrared. Come on guys, focus. Okay, no problem. Let's see. I hope you learnt it now. For after one question. Uttam, Vivan, Singh, Roshini, Saran. Top 5. Wow. Avengers, Siddharth, Navaj, Srinidhi and Harshit. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So kids, question number 2. Come on. This time, you got to get it bang on. Which type of device is touchscreen technology used on? What device? Tablet computers? Is it used? Touchscreen is used on tablets, smartphones, new model laptops, desktops or all of them? Can you make a mistake here? You tell me. There is no way that you guys are going to make a mistake. All of you are going to get it bang on. Are you clear? Right. So come on guys, there are only 5 more seconds left. Quickly, I want you guys to close this very fast. 193 of you got this right. Oh, wow. Awesome guys. Keep it up. Keep it up guys. 193 of you got this right. So Let me see who is at the top of the leaderboard. Looks like Siddharth is well at the top, followed by Ajitesh, Navaj, Srinidhi, Ritika, top 5. Rushi, Ahans, Dipankar, Atharvan, Sai Manoj, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So my dear kids, come on. Question number 3. Touch screen is what? Input device, output device, both input and output, I can't say. Sitter, right? Sitter. A cakewalk sitter for all of you. So, let me see. Time is up. Obviously, input and output, right? Good. See, there are people who said input, output. I want you to look at this video again. First sentence I spoke about when I started the session is touchscreen is an input-output device. This is the first sentence I spoke. 173 of you, most of you got it right. So now, Ajitesh at the top, followed by Dakshyesh, Sai Manoj, Atharvan, Vishwajit, top 5. Rijul, Tungesh, Hrithika, Yutiksha, Nandini, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So question number 4, guys, just one more question to go. Be on your toes. Fourth question. Which touchscreen detect your fingers using sound waves? Is it called as surface acoustic wave touch, projected capacitive touch, infrared or resistive touch? I have repeated a number of times, so I'm not going to stress more. Sound. Clue is given already. Let me see how many of you choose A. 136. There are many of you who chose infrared. Guys, infrared is a light, guys. We are speaking about sound. Surface acoustic wave touch. I said vibrations will be flowing throughout the screen. When you press, the disruption is detected and the touch point is identified. So it's called SOT, surface acoustic wave touch. So 4 questions are over. Now, Ajitesh is at the top, followed by Dakshyesh, Vishwajit, Rijul and Hrithika, top 5. Sai Manoj, Tungesh, Akshneel, Ira, here Ira and Praha, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So my dear kids, moving towards the last question for today. Here we go. Who invented the touch screen? Wow. IBM Simon, Eric Johnson, Steve Jobs, Nikola Tesla. Can you make a mistake here? So my dear kids, time is running. Who invented the first touch screen? Eric Johnson, guys, come on. 211 of you got this right. Superb. So kids, awesome job done. Ajitesh is winning the quiz today, guys. Followed by Dakshyesh, Vishwajit, Rijul, Hrithika. Ajitesh, future Steve Jobs. That's the spirit, Ajitesh. Keep it up. Congratulations to you. Many, many congratulations. Dakshyesh, Vishwajit, Hrithik, Vingesh, Shano, Manoj, Akshneel. Who is that? Ira, Prahas and Rijul. Guys, many congratulations to you as well for making it to the leaderboard. Every one of you guys who could not make it to the leaderboard, it's okay, my dear kids. It's a question of you learning, participating, competing. Keep doing it. Keep trying. You will reach the leaderboard once. All you got to do is make it fast. Hey guys, I hope you liked the session today. Was it informative for all of you? Now you know different types of touch screens, where all it is used, right? And do not forget to hit the like button, and more importantly, newcomers or people who haven't subscribed, please subscribe to the channel. Thank you, kids. I will meet you at 6:30 again. Thank you, Shivani. 6:30 with a lovely, lovely session on Pariksha for SST. Bye-bye. Hi, Vidhi.